آدم إدريس نوح هود صالح إبراهيم لوط إسماعيل إسحاق يعقوب يوسف أيوب شعيب موسى هارون ذو الكفل داود سليمان إلياس اليسع يونس زكريا يحيى عيسى والآخر الخاتم الأنبياء محمد المصطفى.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه وله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. My dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Tonight is a special episode in this program and this series of Lights of Guidance. We reached to the end of our journey, and this is the second episode about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the last episode of this series. It is very, very important. It is very, very emotional as well, especially when you're talking about the best human being who stepped foot on this earth, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who will intercede for his ummah in Yawm al-Qiyamah. After all the prophets decline, he will intercede for everybody. The one who will be resurrected first before any other human being. The one, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who sacrificed his time, his effort, his life, dedicated his life for the cause of Allah. The one who gathered all the qualities of all the prophets of Allah. He was patient at the time of hardship, and he suffered a lot from his people. He was thankful with Allah's blessing. With Allah's blessings, he was thankful. Like Sulaiman alayhi salam, he had everything a person can dream of, but he did not keep anything with him. He gave it to everyone around him. He was patient when he gets sick, when he loses his children, one by one, in front of his eyes. Like Ayyub alayhi salam, he suffered from his people, like Musa alayhi salam, and many other prophets. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you will find the quality from them. Sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Don't forget to say Salah on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam daily. Daily, you make Salah on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, other than the time of prayer. We talked about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a husband, as a father, as a grandfather. Today we talk about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a prophet of Allah, as a nasih, as an advisor, as a caretaker, as someone who cares about his companion sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Every single one of his sahaba think that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving them more attention than anybody else. When he talks, everyone thinks that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is focused on him. That's how he divide his care among his sahaba. Every sahabi got an accolade from Rasulullah, like a gift, like a title. That's a message to our leaders, to the fathers and the mothers, to the employers. Empower those who are under you. Empower those who are following you. Always be positive. Always bring life to their heart and their soul. Always keep the negativity away from them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talks about Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. He says, leave my friend to me. If any one of you does anything, will not reach Abu Bakr, we give him that. He said, the best and the most merciful to my ummah is Abu Bakr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks at Umar and he said, Ya Umar, you are the Faruq. Shaitan runs away from you, scared from you. You are Faruq. Allah distinguished between haqq and batil with you. He gave him that gift. What do you think how Abu Bakr would feel, what Umar feels with Rasulullah himself telling them that? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best person who make a ruling and a judgment in Qada is Ali ibn Abi Talib, his cousin. And he said, Ya Ali, you to me like Harun to Musa, but there is no prophet after me. Means you are not a prophet. Harun was a prophet, but you to me as close as Harun to Musa. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam tells his wife Khadija that Jibreel is giving you salam of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah is giving you salam, Ya Khadija. Assalamu alaykum. And giving you glad tidings with a house made of a pearl in Jannah. There is no exhaustion and there is no sickness. Because she was tired, exhausted. She spent everything for the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم gave glad tidings to Asma, the daughter of Abu Bakr. When she took her belt fabric around her waist and she wrapped the food that Rasulullah and Abu Bakr will take on their journey before they leave the house of Abu Bakr, Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, may Allah will give you one nitaq, one dress, one garment in Jannah because of that. To Asma رضي الله عنها. Rasul صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم, when Safiya, his wife, came crying because the other wives of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم took to her as like you were a Jew, and she came crying, Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, tell them like my father is Harun and my uncle is Musa and my husband is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Who among you has that? He's empowering her صلى الله عليه وسلم, bringing her out of her sadness and her emotion. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم tells Bilal, who was a slave before, and the Arabs, they used to have that attitude toward those who were slaves, and now they are free. So he told him, ya Bilal, I saw or I heard, I was in Jannah yesterday, and I heard your footsteps in Jannah. What were you doing, ya Bilal, to do that? He said, I, Rasulullah, never made wudu except, did wudu except I pray to rak'ah after. He gave him that gift. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever wanted to listen to the Quran coming as fresh as it was revealed, listen from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and recite according to him. And he was the one that will enter the house of Rasulullah without permission. Hudhaifa, he is the one who keeping the secret of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hudhaifa ibn al-Yaman. We can go on and on, my brothers and sisters. But Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passes by Ammar ibn Yasir and his family when they were in Mecca. He said, sabran ala Yasir fa inna wa'idakum al-Jannah. Be patient, you will go to Jannah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam calls Ubay ibn Ka'b. Ubay ibn Ka'b, the Sahabi of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he tells him, ya Ubay, Allah is giving salam to you. Wow. And he is ordering me to recite Surah Al-Bayyinah for you. And you listen. إِنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَنِي أَنْ أَقْرَأَ عَلَيْكَ سُورَةَ الْبَيِّنَةِ. Allah ordered me, Rasulullah, to recite Surah Al-Bayyinah for you, Ya Ubay. So Ubay emotionally overwhelmed and he said, Ya Rasulullah, and Allah called me by name? Allah said my name and you heard it? سَمَّانِي بِاسْمِي قَالَ نَعَمْ سَمَّاكَ بِاسْمِي. Allah called you by name. And he recited Surah Al-Bayyinah for Ubay ibn Ka'b. You see how Rasulullah is constantly empowering the people around him. And this is a lesson for all of us, my brothers and sisters. Empower people around you. You're not going to lose anything. What you are going to win when you put people down? Your wife or your husband, sisters, your son or your daughter. What are you going to get when you compare them to someone that they cannot catch up with? What you are expecting from them, something impossible. When you're putting them down and always negatively talking to them, what are you going to get out of that? What are you going to lose when you empower them and invest in their goodness and their skills and the good qualities? You're not going to lose anything, and you're going to win everything. You're going to win someone loyal, someone happy, someone who have hope, someone who's trying their best. Be their friend. Empower people around you, or communities, all the imams and the sheikhs and muftis and hafiz and mullah and whoever, whatever your name is. How much of empowerment do you do to your community? You just come like the sheikh, the imam, the alim, the scholar, the prestigious person, frowning upon people, coming, delivering the lecture and leaving. What is that? Empower them. Give each one their due respect. If it's older person, stand with them, talk with them, tell them to advise you. If there are youngsters, shake their hand. I tell the people, make a point. When you enter the masjid, shake the hand of the little kids. Shake their hand, admire the way they dress, admire them that they came to the masjid. If they are teenagers, tell them I'm proud of you that you come to the jama'ah, salah. I'm happy that you come to salat al-fajr. Buy them a gift, subhanallah. You don't have to be the imam to do that. Make a point, have gifts, a dollar gift or a pound gift or a few cents gift, and have them in your car. And when you see a son or a daughter or a child or a teenager in the masjid, give them. Make it a point. Subhanallah, so they get attached. So the children see the adults as someone who's empowering them. And the adults see the children as the future. The husbands and the wives and the community, the imams, the leaders, the administration, the council. always be there to empower people around you, not only to criticize. We don't want to be the ones that people see us when we criticize them only. But when they do something good, they look around and they don't find anybody. So Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with his companions, even when they make mistakes, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was there to forgive them. When one of the companions, he even did the high treason, and he sent the news of Rasulullah going to open Mecca to the people in Mecca, but he gets caught before the news reaches there. And so it was about to be executed by Umar ibn al-Khattab, and Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, no. Maybe Allah Azza wa Jalla looked at the people who fought in the Battle of Badr and he said, do whatever you want, Allah forgive you. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When the young man comes and he wants to commit adultery, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam take it easy on him and he forgive him and he made dua for him. Tell him this is wrong. When another companion comes and said, Ya Rasulullah, I made wrong with a woman, but I did not commit adultery and I regret it and I feel very bad. So Rasulullah said, you repent to Allah Azza wa Jalla and regret what you did and not to do it again and pray two rak'ah for Allah Azza wa Jalla. To Allah Azza wa Jalla, Allah forgives you. This is the mercy for mankind. He's not there to stone people and kill people and chop people's hand like people think. He was rahmah for mankind, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. When an Arabi comes and urinates in the masjid and the Sahaba are about to attack him, what did Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam do? He said, let him finish. Let him finish. Don't cut his urination, maybe he will get hurt. Let him finish. So he's sitting there, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, for a couple of minutes watching the man finishing that. Subhanallah. And then after that he said, what's going to cost you? Put some bucket of water on it and to be clean. Then he tells him, it's not like that. This masjid is for prayer, it's not like that. And the man gets affected by what Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. Another Arabi comes and he was rough with Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So he said to Umar ibn al-Khattab, go give him and give him extra because you scared him off. And then he comes and said, Ya Allah, forgive me and Muhammad only. Don't forgive these guys. And Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, no, you are making it tight. The mercy of Allah encompasses everybody. While another Arabi calls Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Ya Muhammad, with his name. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Ha'um, yes. He answered him the same way. They would not accept it from the other companions. They are not supposed to raise their voice with Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But he is dealing with the Arab according to their culture. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This is our Prophet, this is our Messenger. This is mercy for mankind. We learn from him. When he was angry, when the limits of Allah transgressed, we listen, we learn from Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When he was happy, we learn from him. With his wife, we learn from him. With his son, with his daughters, we learn from him, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. With the Sahaba, we learn from him sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. More coming to learn from the story of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after the break. So don't go anywhere because we are still with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We pray to Allah azza wa jal that we stay with him for the rest of our lives. Stay with us. I'll see you after the break.
As-salatu ala nabi wassalamu ala rasul wal-anbiya'i al-mursalin kulluhum mukramun. As-salatu ala nabi wassalamu ala rasul wal-anbiya'i al-mursalin kulluhum مكرمون.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Welcome back, my brothers and sisters. And this is the last segment in this beautiful series of Lights of Guidance with the most shining and brightest of lights with Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. We saw together and we learned together how to deal with our spouses, seeing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the husband. How to be a community member, seeing Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam as-sadiq al-ameen, the truthful and the honest. Seeing how Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam dealt with his daughter, with his grandchildren. Seeing how Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam dealt with his companions and how he, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, empowered them and how what we should do. Now we learn with Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in different aspects of life. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was kind to people. He jokes with people, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When a person comes to Rasulullah and said, Ya Rasulullah, I need a camel. I need a camel. From Sadaqah, I need a camel. I don't have a camel. So Rasulullah sallam said, Nahmiluka ala waladin naqa. We will give you to the camel's baby. Walad al-Naqa means the production of the she-camel. So the man thought that he will give him a baby camel. That's the word, how the word is understood in Arabic. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, how can I ride a baby camel? So Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, camel is the son of the she-camel. So this is the production of that. So Rasulullah jokes with him, but he jokes with the truth. When a woman comes to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, said, Ya Rasulullah, enter Jannah. He said, no old woman will enter Jannah. She cries, he said, because you're going to be young when you go there. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to love one of the companions. He used to make him happy and say jokes and all of that. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He goes to the marketplace and hugs him from behind. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, and he said, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, who is going to buy this slave? Of course, this is a slave of Allah Azza wa Jal. Man yashtari hadha al-abd, who's going to buy this slave? Then he looks at Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, said, Ya Rasulullah, then I will not be sold for anything. Yeah, I'm not a good commodity. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, but you are a very high commodity with Allah Azza wa Jal. So this is how Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was his sahab. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was kind to animals. And he said, a woman will enter hellfire because she was not kind to a cat. And a man enters Jannah because they were kind to a dog. A camel comes and complains to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam about how hard it is, and his master is not feeding him well and putting his owner not and putting too much load on him, overloading him and giving him less food and drink. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave advice to that person about his camel. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was connected even with plants. When he had the trunk of the tree that he gave khutbah on, and then he moved to a member, a few steps were made for him, the trunk of the tree, they heard a voice as the voice of a little baby. And Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam went and wiped and put his hand on it until the trunk of the tree calmed down. Was connected Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with his surroundings. Rasulullah was connected with his surroundings Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, with the plants, with the trees, with the animals, the humans, with everybody. He was rahmah, mankind, to everybody. With the jinn, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave them the glad tidings of Jannah. He gave them the ahkam, the rulings. He recited Quran for them. And Allah mentioned that in the Quran, وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. When we send a group of jinn to you to recite Quran, and they believed in Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and they went. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was good to everybody around him. And this is what we need. Do you want to be the person, whenever you enter a place, you make that place lively, you make people want you, want to listen to you, want to be with you, or you are that person when you enter, everybody's scared, everybody's hiding, everybody's running, and everybody cannot wait until you finish and leave? Which kind of person you want? What kind of husband you want to be? What kind of wife you want to be? What kind of son, daughter, employer, employee, leader, masjid council, doctor, engineer, teacher? What kind of person you want to be? Focus. Focus on you being a slave of Allah, abd of Allah. See, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were lenient with his companions. A companion who cannot get married because he did not look handsome, he did not look good, no woman wants him. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell him, go and marry from that house one of the most beautiful girls from Al-Ansar. And he goes there. And he said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent me to marry your daughter. And they could not say anything. They were debating the father and the mother. And the daughter comes and said, why are you debating about? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made the rule, I will marry him. She marries him and he dies as a shaheed after a few days. And everybody want to marry that girl who married the shaheed that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam testified for Jannah for. They were like that. That was the community of the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, men and women obeying Allah and His Rasul. So where are we from that, my brothers and sisters? We went through all this series to show this example, to come to this moment now. This is the moment of truth. And my question to myself and to everybody who's listening today, listening now, watching me now, the question is, who are you? Answer that question. Write it in a piece of paper. Who are you? Who am I? Abd of Allah? XYZ, say your name. I have that money worth. Who are you? And based on that, what do you want to be? How you want to die? In what state? when you're standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jal now, what you would wish you would look like or sound like or be addressed with? Believer among the people of Jannah? You go and behind Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, full of confidence that you fulfilled the amana. Who are you and what you want to be? What you want to be in this dunya and how you would like to be addressed in Yawm Al-Qiyamah? This is the moment of truth in this series. You listen to all the stories of the prophets. Now we know who were they and what they were trying to do and what they wanted to be. All of them, we discussed that. And now we defined who's Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what he did to the people around him, what he wanted to be. Abdan Shakura, thankful servant of Allah, that's what he wanted to be. Allah sent him as Rahman Al-Alameen, and he was. Allah sent him to deliver the message, and he did. Allah sent him to give glad tidings to people, and he delivered, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah sent him to be a role model, and he lived up to it. Now it's our turn. Who are you? What you want to be? And how much are you doing to fulfill that? And how much are you behaving? And how are you behaving based on who you are? Are you generous? You consider yourself generous? Show yourself. Don't show anybody, just write. What did you do to live up to that? Are you knowledgeable? What did you do to live up to that? You love Allah and His Rasul? How much it shows in your actions? You love the community? How many hours you volunteer? How many lives you changed? Or you at least attempted to change? Who are you? And are you living up to that? Fill the blanks. I am, fill the blanks. And for every word you add, try to answer this next question. How much did I do to live up to that? Not based on people, based on yourself. This is what we learned from the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبَرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَتَفْصِيلَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says at the end of Surah Yusuf, after he mentioned the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, in their stories, scholars said the story of Yusuf and his brothers, or the stories, all the stories mentioned in the Quran. In their stories, truly there is an admonition, there is a lesson to be learned, there is a message. For who? لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ, those who have minds, who have the ability to analyze and reflect and think and ponder. This was not a made-up statement or a made-up story with no origin, with no truth in it. It is with truth. And it is coming to fulfill or to continue what is revealed before, and it's coming to explain everything, and it is guidance, lights of guidance, it is guidance. The qasas of al-anbiya is guidance and mercy. Mercy, because Allah's mercy, we err, we make mistakes, and Allah's mercy, He sent us messengers to guide us. لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ, for those who believe. So in all the stories that we learned through this program, episode after episode, is to come to that truth. Who are you? And how much are you doing? Or are you willing to do to live up to who are you? And when you stand in front of Allah Azza wa Jal in Yawm Al-Qiyamah, what are you going to be answering? What did you do, my brothers and sisters? No excuse for us anymore. You see what is happening to the ummah around you? No excuse. At least do the dua. If you cannot change it physically, financially, you try your best. If you cannot do, at least do the dua. Raise your hand sincerely and cry for what is happening to the Muslim ummah. Worse has happened. We came out of it. We bounced back strong. But it is time to connect with Allah Azza wa Jal. That is what's our focus. Focus on who you are and what you are able to do for Allah's sake. Try your best. Study. Seek the knowledge. And seek the knowledge and seek the knowledge. This is the end of this program. We'll emphasize on that. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came with knowledge. And we need to seek the knowledge because it is our way out from all this turbulence and our problems. Be polite, be a student, and learn, and be good, and respect our scholars, respect the leaders of this ummah. Because how we respect ourselves, the sign is how we respect our scholars. take care of them, make sure that their dunya is taken care of, so they help us take care of our akhirah. Don't treat them as employees, don't treat them as a low life. Don't treat your children only if they are smart, they are not sheikhs, but if they are not smart, they can be sheikhs or religious people. My brothers and sisters, I want to finish this halqa with the salah and salam on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. The salah and salam of Allah be upon all his prophets and messengers. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. The last of our statements is to say praise be to the Lord سبحانه وتعالى, the Lord of the worlds. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
آدم إدريس نوح صالح إبراهيم لوط إسماعيل إسحاق يعقوب يوسف أيوب شعيب موسى هارون ذو الكفل داود سليمان إلياس اليسع يونس زكريا يحيى عيسى آدم إدريس نوح صالح إبراهيم لوط إسماعيل إسحاق يعقوب يوسف أيوب شعيب موسى هارون ذو الكفل داود سليمان إلياس اليسع يونس زكريا يحيى عيسى والآخر الخاتم الأنبياء محمد المصطفى.